the simplest way of saying what Yoko is to me and what I am to her is that before we met, we were half a person, you know. There is an old myth about people being half and the other half being in the sky or in heaven or something, or the other side of the universe, or the mirror image bit. But we are two halves, and together we're a whole.
It's a very convenient whole too, because, like, you know, it's almost like, say, if you had one hand separate from your body that's working there, you know. So we're just sort of separate body-wise, just for convenience sake, you know.
Thing isn't big enough. I mean, it's big, but so we need a lot of them. Then we've got to decide how many in each city, so can you
Yes, but imagine? The point is, yes, I understand. But you see, the thing is, so billboard we don't do, just posters in Europe. That's all right. But in Paris we do the billboard,
well, they can
right?
do billboard in whatever billboard size they have, you know. But it's in each place it should be billboard and posters.
Yeah.
So how many, you know? I mean, how many covers are...
Berlin,
you know, when
Paris.
Somebody's advertising something, how many posters do they use, you know? Around the city,
a couple of hundred.
Around the city. Couple of hundred.
No, not a couple of hundred. Even for my small concert in New York, I used about like 1,000 to 2,000.
Small ones.
Well,
small
that ones. Size of the post. Okay, so 2,000 in each city. Yeah. And that's it. So tell them to go ahead, and big ones where they can grab it. So that's it, is it? Okay, we'll do it any way you like, okay?
A couple of routine signatures.
Yes.
That's self-explanatory. Do you know that, remember those composers that we had?
Do you want to sit down? Yes, every day. Oh, beautiful, great.
Great.
So I'll get a copy of all the films made and send them to you, too.
Thanks. Yeah, the slides coming out beautiful. All that thing with the bottles.
Oh, yes, yeah, and the film, too.
Yes.
Yeah, some of the film's out of focus and all that, but most of it's there, you know.
Hello, hello.
This is Ian,
just grabbed the editor.
Hello.
How long do you think you can go on being a practicing Beatle?
It depends how I feel and how they feel, you know, when it happens.
I mean, there comes a time when it's time for a Beatle product, and we always make that decision whether to make it or not, you know. Because sometimes we go through hell recording, sometimes we don't, you know.
Yeah.
And sometimes it's not worth it. And now, the problem now is, in the old days, when we needed an album, Paul and I got together and produced an album, or produced enough songs for it. Nowadays, there's four of us, three of us writing prolifically, and trying to fit it on one album. And it's not like we're wrestling in the studio trying to get a song on, we all do it the same way, you know. We take it in turns to record a track, you know. But usually George lost out, you know, because Paul and I are tougher. You know, but it's not where it gets to, we don't want to fight about it, you know. Now, half the tracks on Abbey Road, I'm not on something. You know, half the tracks on the double album, and way back, it depends. We're not always on, there's sometimes only two Beatles on a track. But it's got to the situation, if we have the name Beetle on it, it sells, you know. And when we begin to think like that, then there's something wrong, you know.
Then you begin to get...
Well, then you begin to think, what are we selling, you know? 3485. Toronto. He's originally from New York, and then he was in London. 416-363-3485. Okay, now we've only told him about the event so far, and that we'd send Kosh up, because Kosh has to look over this museum as well to tell us about, you know, to give us an idea about the show. But we might go to, you know, the guy wants us to sign these lithographs out of the country or something. So we might go to Toronto to do it if we can fix a proper deal with Mario that he's definitely going to let us have an exhibition. What? Would it have to be in the next 3 weeks? Yeah, well, we've got the best PR in France handling it in France. Great. She's been knitting this for my birthday, which is October the 9th. I'm so
excited. You see how busy I was.
Great.
I am a very busy housewife, to put it mildly.
Metal salt and pepper shakers, $6.
Oh no, they have to say that it was all a hoax.
What was?
Lennon lying.
John Lennon doesn't affront the Queen by sending his MBE. He doesn't make a ha'penth of difference to attitudes on Biafra and Vietnam or to the place of his drug-orientated record in the charts. He makes an ass of himself. He does affront hundreds of ordinary people who are proud to hold this rather ordinary decoration.
And I find a lot of people have this thing that they still don't feel that you communicate on the peace thing as much as, in some cases, they'd like you to.
They're having problems in us communicating on the peace thing. That's all we're communicating, the peace thing. That's all they need to know. It's like if you see an advert for something on telly, it can have all sorts of jazz going on, birds dancing, white horses, cars revving up. But the product couldn't be a cigarette lighter, you know. And the cigarette lighter is the thing that comes over subliminally, and the cigarette lighter is the thing they buy.
But the end product is to make that desirable, isn't it, too?
Yeah, so that's what we're doing, is doing a campaign of advertising. But the campaign hasn't been going long as, like, Coca-Cola's or Shell, and the identification symbols aren't as well known, you know. And it's going to take us a few years for them to know when we say peace what it means, you know. It's just like that. We've been on this kick for 2 years, and only a year solid selling of the product. And it's going to take a bit of time, you know, for it to sink in. Somebody keeps checking in hotels in our name. You know, like it happened in Wales. They booked an entire floor for Mr. Lennon and party at the Bellevue Royal Hotel Aberystwyth.
Oh, I didn't see this. Did you in the Guardian? It's very nice.
Let's get the song. Take the responsibility, you know. It's like people used to say, Beatles changed the whole of Britain's image, or Beatles were the leaders of the movements, you know.
This is true.
He's got to walk backwards. Think about the last 10 years.
John, the 60s has been a time in which the attitudes of younger people have changed pretty dramatically when you compare with earlier decades. And you have been responsible for this change. How would you describe the way in which young people's thinking has changed in this decade?
And that's the bit they can't do, you know, they can't handle it. Or even black magic, man, they can't touch it, you know, just do that and Dracula runs away. So that's all true, you know, and they don't stand a chance, and I'm supremely positive. You know. I don't know whether I answered it, but...
Fabulous. And I've never understood why it is that you've got to have a long face.
Yeah, and that's exactly what
be very pompous in order to be very serious.
But nobody believes the pompous thing really anymore, because all the politicians do the pompous thing about Nixon, the all-American boy with a family and a wife and sport and rowing and whatever he does, and pat the dog. You know, nobody falls for that anymore. You know. But the people who say, why don't you do it like a politician with a butch haircut and an eye-tie suit, you know, because they're only just about... they're the ones that the politicians are fooling all the time with a butch haircut and a tie suit and patting the dog and picture of the family and the whores kept in the back room downstairs. Just tell us what's going on today.
It's all Japanese today.
Yeah, and what about the evening? That's when do we finish?
Two more Japanese interviews. And then we should be able to leave by about 6 o'clock.
We'd like to give you this, and maybe you can play it on your program, some of it. It's all our product.
Oh, super. Is that your wedding album?
Yes,
and that's the one before. And there's a single and information on films. Great smell on new records, that's all right.
Okay, this is John and Yoko here, and we're just sending peace and love to you from London.
For
the new year, and let's hope in the 70s we really have peace throughout the world and we can get it together.
Peace and love.
Thank you.
That's great. Lovely. That's... We shall then play a bit of your wedding album.
Sure.
Oh, beautiful. I was dying to ask you what it was like being married to an Oriental, because I'm also married to an Oriental.
Oh, well, you must realise that you don't notice, you know, every now and then you suddenly think, oh, yes. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Do you think she's sexy?
Yes, I think she's the sexiest bitch on earth.
We do give us some message for Japanese fans.
Think of the word children.
Missing. I think in one word, you know. Missing, that's it.
You're not.
See, our children are missing, as it were, you know, from our lives, folks.
Capital letter, M.
What do you mean?
I mean, it's missing in capital letter.
Oh, yes, yes, so we're missing our children.
Insecurity.
It's just fear, you know. It's just... I can't think of anything else about it except for it's fear.
Well, money doesn't solve it.
We all have it. Money doesn't solve it, and work doesn't solve it. But work's the best cure for anything, really. And you've no time to be insecure if you're doing something.
Work is divine, or whatever.
Yeah. So when we're not working, we get pretty depressed. Because people think, "What's work to you?" You know, it's all gimmicks and events. But events are work, you know. And gimmicks are work. It's either brain work or physical work, whatever. It's both. And then that hides the insecurity or covers it. In fact, it makes you secure because you're not insecure when you're working. You must know that.
Death.
Death is, I hope we both die together. Yes. One of our greatest fears is one dying before the other, you know, even 3 minutes. And what about tomorrow?
Tomorrow, pop interviews. Not really decided. Various.
Yeah, aren't we?
Pop papers.
Are we recording?
We're recording at 7 o'clock in your mind.
And two pictures of me!
Ladies like that.
Thank you.
you say whatever you feel.
Yes.
Then you tell it to me. And then whatever I feel.
John Smith, can you hear me?
I've got
something
to Kev.
Yes, go on.
Yes.
You heard her. Mal. Mal. He heard her.
They're cheaper by the hundred weight.
It's very cheap.
Dear Mr. Lemon, from information I received while using a Ouija board, I believe that there will be an attempt to assassinate you. The spirit that gave me this information was Brian Epstein. He said the attempt was made in place of March 6th, 17th, and Mr. Epstein also said that Paul McCartney was alive in London. Is that true? Please take this letter seriously, because I would very much be afraid if you allowed it. Well, it's funny you never said anything to me in Athens.
Yes, the only reason, if I'm going to get on the front page, I might as well get on the front page with the word peace.
But you've made yourself ridiculous.
To some people, I don't
care.
If it
you're too good for
if
what
it saves
doing.
Lives.
You don't think you... Oh, my dear boy, you're living in another netherland.
Well, you talk to them.
You don't think you saved a single life.
Maybe we'll
you
save some in the future.
You probably helped
the
old turkey
maybe
move
next
up
year
the
didn't, it didn't do a bit of use. No, it's still gone down, so it didn't do anything.
But, I mean, you don't equate... the civil war that's going on in Nigeria with that. And then talk about, well, this is my form of protest.
Well,
because
look.
People in anti-war campaigns are too serious.
Yes.
And they get battered. What do you know about a protest movement anyway?
I know a lot
it
about it.
It's a lot more than sending your chauffeur in your car back to Buckingham Palace.
You're just a snob about it. The only way
you're
to make...
You're a fake. I mean, I know. In England it's kind of smart not
everything
to be too serious about
smile.
Anything.
Everything needs a smile, you know.
I see.
For instance, even if...
The Pinkville Massacre, ha ha ha. Can't you give up something else that would mean a little bit more?
It doesn't, it's not the sacrifice. You can't get that into your head, can you? You've stated a half a dozen times the MBE is irrelevant. I agree. It was no sacrifice to get rid of the MBE because it was an embarrassment.
Then what kind of a protest did you make? You said, I don't know much about Nigeria.
We did an advertising campaign for peace.
Very
can you understand
one.
That?
No, I can't.
A very big advertising campaign for peace.
I think it's vulgar and self-aggrandizing.
Well, you think
are
it's...
you advertising
oh,
John
do you want,
Lennon or
do you
peace?
Want nice middle-class gestures for peace?
Maybe.
And intellectual manifestos written by a lot of half-witted intellectuals and nobody reads them.
Oh.
That's the trouble with the peace movement.
Well, it just seems another netherland. I mean, I can't think of anyone who seems more remote from
well,
the ugliness of what's
someday.
Happening than you.
Well, I hope
I do see you getting up on a Tuesday morning and thinking, let's see, what should we do today and what war is going
well,
on?
Well, that's your imagination, you know, really. I mean,
you know, you carry on. Why don't you make a film while you're at it?
I'm someone who admired you very much.
Well, I'm
you
sorry
know,
you liked
we
the
have,
old mop tops, dear, and you thought it was I was very satirical
well, I mean,
and witty,
on the
and you liked Hard Day's Night, love, but I've grown up, but you obviously haven't.
Have you?
Yes, folks.
What have you grown up to?
No, 29.
Yes, yes. How is Greece?
It's beautiful.
We did a nice war protest on the Army TV while we were there.
By the way, you know.
I suppose you didn't like us going to Greece, eh? You think you shouldn't go to a fascist country like Greece, and but it's all right to live in a fascist country like Britain or America, is it?
I think America's a good place to live right now because, I mean, if you were interested or committed and not too cowardly, you might conceivably make a difference by what you did. That's one of the
well, we've been trying to go to America to do something for the last 7 or 8 months,
oh,
but I can't get in.
Oh, yes,
we'll
they
turn
take it
in.
Too seriously. You don't understand how they protest, my dear. They don't... They
listen,
go on
will you tell me, what were they singing at the moratorium?
Which, I mean, the moratorium,
the,
it says throughout the
well,
nation.
The one here, the recent big one, they were singing Give Peace a Chance, you know.
A song of yours, probably.
Well, yes, and it was written specifically for them.
Where are we, and what is this, and what have you have to do with the moratorium? So they sang one of your songs.
Well, if you...
Great song, sure, but is that all you can say about that, the moratorium?
You were saying that in America they're so serious about the protest movement.
Yes, they are.
But they were so flippant that they were singing a happy-go-lucky song, which happens to be one I wrote, and I'm glad they sang it. And when I get there, I'll sing it with them, when I get in. And that was a message from me to America or to anywhere. that I used my songwriting ability to write a song that we could all sing together. And I'm proud that they sang it at the moratorium. I wouldn't have cared if they'd sang We Shall Overcome, but it just so happens they sang that, and I'm proud of it, and I'll be glad to go there and sing with them.
Make it jolly.
I will make it jolly.
Yes, you know, we have to make it jolly.
Why?
We can't all afford to be neurotic. Jolly,
maybe we might stop the war. You
By
know.
Being jolly?
Yes, because the thing is, when you're happy and when you're smiling, you don't want to kill somebody, do you? You know, it's when you're very serious you start to think about violence and death and killing. I mean, have you ever seen a person killing somebody with a smile on his face and being happy? No, killers are unhappy people. And they're violent because they're so unhappy and so damn serious.
Mrs. Lennon, we're boring each other, so I'll go away quietly.
See you about that? I mean...
Thank you. Goodbye.
Well, I think that's what you wanted.
But the last point was a good point, and she didn't want to respond
to it. She didn't hear anything. You're the BBC, are you?
Yeah.
You're on.
No, this is as well.
When?
In his interview. Well, can I come on the car with you?
Yeah, your radio.
Where are you going? Yeah.
Well, we're going somewhere to a friend, you know. Could you come tomorrow?
Well, it's a bit late then.
What's it about?
It's about this thing about, you know, playing Jesus and this.
Well, I've heard nothing about it.
Well, this is it.
I've heard,
I know. It's not on, but so, it's such a sort of everybody's talking about it, and you know, it just seems a good idea to sort of get it all cleared up.
Well, that's it. I don't know anything about it, and I don't want to do it. And God bless you.
Okay, John.
Okay, bye bye. Mr. and Mrs. Smith.
Well, fortunately, I suddenly came across the idea of doing that whispering piece again.
Unfortunately, we did it yesterday and we could do it again today.
Well, in the end, probably we'll do whispering piece many, 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 many times. Fortunately, I'm in love with you.
Unfortunately, I'm in love with you too.
But in the end, I think we'll agree.
Fortunately, we don't know.
Unfortunately, we think we know.
But in the end, we'll find out.
Unfortunately.
No. Fortunately.
Yes, fortunately. Fortunately. I think I'm sleepy enough tonight to go to sleep.
Unfortunately, we'll never sleep with all this going on.
In the end, you'll have a nice dream.
Fortunately, that's possible.
John, I had a dream. It was about this man came out and he said, we have to be very careful now, because everybody around us, near us or far away, they're all wishing us to separate. Not intentionally, but just subconsciously, you know. And then this woman came out and said, yes, he's right, and that we're terribly accident-prone now, because, say, if you're walking or something, they're trying to pull us so that our movement would be awkward. So that she said, never to cross the street without each other. And then I saw this field, you see, and I just immediately understood, because there were mists, but it was just about to clear. And she said, well, the mist is going to clear in a year's time, you know. So it's another year.
Morning, Jim.
Morning, Basil.
You, dear.
Tea?
Is it, Minnie?
It's not that.
Yeah. should say, Dow Chemicals, 1959, this stuff.
Yes, 1929, I was.
Who's it like? Cheers to the past. But I'll tell you what, I said, it's something different than what you want.
So it's one thing to write about a strange couple who's in bed, you know, doing the bed event and all that, you know, write a song about it, for instance, you know. But it's another thing to really do it in actual life, you know. And, well, many, you know, like Samuel Beckett or Jean Genet, those people wrote about weird couples, you know, and it's performing in a theater, you know. But then the Beckett, what Beckett is saying is, well, this is theater, you know, and come to the theater and look at this old people and all that under the spotlight, etc. But what we started to do was, instead of writing a play about it, all that, you know, we just started to do it in real life. So the whole world is a theater, actually. I mean, the audience or whatever, and we're just doing it on, you know, the Hilton was the stage, you know, whatever. And it's a more direct kind of communication.
Thanks to